age 27 is kind of, I know it's not like being 95 or anything, but musically speaking, it's a little bit more of a dangerous age. Get all these talented musicians who died at age 27. But then somebody said to me, Eryn, they were living like way rougher than you. They were all on drugs and alcohol and stuff. So I don't think you have anything to worry about.
Lots of alcohol.
Not being superstitious. But poor Hank Williams, they say all sorts of things about him. But I'm always on Hank's side. That is my man right there. So don't you go talking bad about him. I'll put you in your place.
All right.
But I think the poor thing had a hard life and just you get worn out. And I think that's what happened with him. And he died when he was just 2 years older than me.
Yeah.
Life cut way too short. But I'm so thankful for the good music that God blessed him to create. And there's so many songs. I mean, you can just sit down and listen to his record, and he can just capture human emotion so perfectly. And one thing I admire about him is you don't have to go pulling a dictionary off the shelf to know what he's talking about and for him to hit you right in your heart about whatever you're going through in life. Just great music. But this is one that the story goes that his wife, Audrey, took him to Nashville and was determined to get him into Fred Rose's office, Mr. Rose of A. Cuff Rose Publishing Company. She wanted Mr. Rose to see what a great songwriter Hank Williams was. And so he listened to some of Hank's songs, and he said, you're very good, but I want to see, you know, how good you really are. So I'm going to take your wife out to lunch, and when we come back, I want you to have a song written for me. And here is the scenario that I want you to write about. You write about a fella who's walking down the street and he sees his old girlfriend with somebody new.
Right.
And so Audrey and Mr. Rose went to lunch, they came back, and Hank Williams came up with this song, sang it in his office. Mr. Rose signed him up to be a songwriter for the publishing company, and the rest is history.